We planned all these places keeping Peling city as a base. So our stay at Peling was over and it was time for South Sikkim. We packed our saddles up once again with the target of reaching another pristine hill town, Ravangla, which is about 50 km from Peling city. This distance was not a great deal, so as the road. We reached Ravangla by afternoon. Without wasting any time, we headed for the famous tourist attraction of Ravangla, the Buddha Park. With a 130 feet statue of Buddha at the center, the Tathagata Tsal was constructed between 2006 to 2013. The statue was blessed by the 14th Dalai Lama in the year 2013. We had milkshake and homemade cake in one of the cafes, bought some souvenirs and spent some quality time walking on the beautifully decorated paths. There is a museum at the base of the statue, whose walls are colorfully painted with the life history of Gautam Buddha. We also walked to the monastery, which is situated just behind the back door of the park. The path to the monastery was serene, covered with trees and colorful prayer flags. It was foggy and cold, but felt so beautiful that we stayed in the park till it was dark and time for closure. Our first destination today was Temi Tea Garden. Round about 20 km through twisty roads, Temi is the only tea garden in Sikkim famous for producing superior quality tea. The tea produced here is fully organic and has a high demand in the international market. The road to the garden is also going through backcutting and construction work. Therefore, 20 km took almost 1.5 hours. There is a beautiful resort amidst the garden called the Cherry Resort. We sat on the terrace of the resort for some hot chocolate, and the infinity tea plant view all round made our day. Further down was the Temi Tea Factory and Cooperative. I bought two different types of tea from the cooperative. My husband is not much of a flavored tea person, but I love the smell. And they were pretty expensive too. In the second half, after a quick brunch, we headed for Ralong Monastery. Even with broken road, the road to Ralong was extraordinary, as there were almost no sign of human. On our whole journey up and down, we probably saw two local cars crossing us. So however the road condition may be, the way to Ralong and back was eminent to me, at least due to this spectacular reason. This old monastery has an immense collection of paintings and thangkas. Standing on the terrace of the monastery, we saw young students from the monastery were playing football. On our way back, we thought of visiting the Buddha Park once again, but it was almost dark and we had a lot of packing ahead. Today, our target was to reach Bengal as far as we could go. Our trip was over. We first reached Namchi, which was around 26 km from Ravangla. Here we got stuck for more than 2 hours as the clutch cable of our bike was broken. We had to get a mechanic and get it fixed as we had a long way ahead. Namchi is also famous for Char. It's a colorful park with 29 hectares of area with a large car park with a nice and clean budget hotel serving vegetarian food. In the center here is a large structure of Shiva. Around the statue, replicas of Char, namely Badrinath Dham, Jagannath Dham, Dwarka Dham and Rameshwaram Dham are present. The entry fee to the park is 50 per person. From Namchi, we chose the shortest route to Melli, which was around 30 km. The road condition was terrible. It was steep and all messed up. So it took quite some time to reach Melli and enter the soil of Bengal. From Melli, we rode about 410 km and reached Raigonj by 9 p.m. via the shortcut bypass of Dalkhola. We called it a day and took refuge in a hotel in Raigonj. I won't say that we completed Sikkim. A whole state so beautiful is impossible to complete in just two short expeditions. Rather, I would say this trip marked our success of covering the most popular and favored destinations of Sikkim. Like Herman Melville truly said, "It is not down in any map. True places never are." So we will return to Sikkim someday to explore those true places out.